Well, one Christmas tradition for many around the world is to watch the Queen's Christmas Day message. But just how does the royal family celebrate Christmas and what are some of the traditions? Mm. Our royal reporter, Neil Shaun, is in London to take us through a very royal Christmas. Merry Christmas,
Merry
Neil.
Merry Christmas, Neil. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Now, run us through a typical Christmas Day with the Queen.
Well, and basically, it starts on Christmas Eve, right? That's the big start, because they all start to arrive and everything like that. And then the big day itself, it's very, very regimented. Let me tell you, girls, if you are ever invited by the royals for Christmas, you have between 9 and 14 frock changes whole Christmas period. But... yeah, I mean, it's a lot, Ange, you know what I mean? It really is a lot. You've got to take a lot to go. And you can't get out of it, you know, because it's so segmented about what they're going to do. Basically, breakfast is a light breakfast, then it's straight to church. And then after church, you know, you have lunch at 1 o'clock. And then the biggie, of course, is to sit down in the main lounge to watch the Queen's speech, probably with Mariah Carey singing in the background and a chocolate orange on your lap.
I noticed on that program of events they exchange gifts on Christmas Eve. Do they actually open the gifts? And what do you get, you know, a woman like the Queen who once had does have an empire? Yeah. What do you get a woman who has everything?
She's got everything.
Well, you know, that's a great question, actually, Peter. What do you get the woman that's got everything? Well, basically, yeah, you're correct. The presents are opened on Christmas Eve. That goes back to their German ancestry. And the problem is that the presents that you give, you can't get anything ostentatious, anything big. So the Queen likes, you know, sort of fun, impersonal gifts. I was kind of thinking, you know, perhaps maybe, you know... perhaps the Queen could give Meghan, like, an ancestral kit to see if she really is related to Thomas Markle. You know, check that out while you're busy. You know, or maybe something like lose your own sister in 10 days from Kate, you know? The thing is, the Queen herself... keep up. The thing is, the Queen herself... Harry bought her this gift a few years ago. Do you remember those fishes that sort of flapped on a board?
Yeah.
It was a singing salmon, and she loved this, yeah. She apparently loved this. And Kate and William a few years ago got Harry a grow-your-own-girlfriend kit. I was kind of hoping it might be a grow-your-own-boyfriend, but there you go. You know?
Well, we know there's been some issues, apparently, between Kate and Meghan. Any fights at the dinner table?
Oh, yes. Now, this is what... kind of, we're all going to be watching this, you know, on sort of Christmas Day. You know, when they go down and they get walked to church, everybody's going to look into Kate and Meghan to see if they get on. Now, I kind of, you know, you have to take all of this stuff with a pinch of salt, because basically there's a story broken today now that's saying that William and Catherine will be down at their own home, you know, at Amner Hall, and basically Meghan and Harry will be staying in Sandringham. Now, Sandringham is a nice place, don't get me wrong, it's a palace, obviously, but it's not that big, and the family's expanded over the last few years. So, you know, there isn't room for everybody. And the William and Catherine home is only sort of 2 miles down the road. But I think we'll all be seeing if there's any glitches of sort of friction and stuff like that. I hope not, though, because Christmas is a time for families, isn't it? You know, that's what it's all about.
And pressure.
Speaking of which, Meghan Markle's mother will be joining the royal family for Christmas Day. That's is it not. Usual that the in-laws do Christmas with the Queen?
Do you know, Ange, let me tell you, that's not true. No, that was a story that sort of perpetuated. You know, Doria has never been coming. You know, there was this story saying, no, the Queen, you know, decided to invite her because she didn't want Meghan to be on her own. Can you imagine the Queen, you know, on the cell phone going, now, Doria, what are you doing at Christmas, love? Do you fancy popping down to Sandringham? Oh, OK. No, she's staying over in the States as far as we know. But she will be coming, obviously, in the new year. It's going to be a busy time for her, of course, becoming a grandmother. But no, there's going to be no sort of outside family, unless, of course, the mad sister turns up at the gate with a Christmas card saying, let me in, you know.
Every family's got one of those.
Can you imagine that? It would be fun. It would
has
be fun.
Guy, just that guy finished,
for us media.
Neil, has that guy finished his speech yet from the wedding? I mean, that's maybe why they're all held up waiting for that. I got to get you folks married. Now, Neil Shaun and I go back along.
He was fabulous, though.
He was the best. He was the highlight for me, apart from... few other bits. Now, it's been a huge year for the Royals, Neil, and what do you think is in store for them in 2019, you know, apart from inviting you to the palace many, many times as the Studio 10 representative?
Oh, thank you, Jono, or should I call you Boy George? The thing is, yes, a big 2019. That picture gave me shockwaves, let me tell you. A big 2019 for them. We know we've got a royal baby, and then we've got a royal US tour for Harry and Meghan. I tell you, on a serious note, what's going to be interesting is, on that tour, whether they ever get to meet President Trump and whether they go together or will Harry be sent alone? Because if you remember, in that conversation that Thomas Markle spoke about, he said that, you know, Harry had said, let's give Trump a chance, whereas we know Meghan's real sort of theory on that. The royals themselves have got to book their ideas up because today it was revealed that the hardest working royal of 2018 was, of course, Her Royal Highness, the Princess Royal, Princess Anne. Uh-huh. She has done more engagements and more than any one of them at all. So, you know, you do say hats off to Anne. She gets a bit of a bad reputation, but she's a lovely lady who does a good job for the British royals.
And now, what rule do all members of the royal family have to abide by over the festive period?
Don't get drunk.
Don't get drunk. Oh, like all of us.
I love this, Andrew. Right? Basically, can you imagine? I mean, we've all known a few bitter queens in our time, let's be honest. But when you're at Sandringham, right? And when you're at Sandringham, it's what the Queen wants to do. So imagine you and me think to ourselves, oh, a bit bored, can we slide off to bed? You cannot go to bed until the Queen goes to bed. She's the first person. Once she's gone, you can go. Basically, when you sat around watching the Queen's speech and stuff on Christmas Day, everybody has to go. There is no excuses. And you sit around and she sits a little bit at the back. So you have to look interested. You can't snack, you can't chew gum, you can't have a cup of tea. All eyes are fixed on the Queen. And then apparently, and this is a good source, she then sort of wants a few reviews and she's not bothered whether you didn't like certain bits or whatever. But can you imagine if you're not featured enough in it? And you can imagine Charles and Camilla saying, we only got 2 seconds, not very good.
Yeah. And what do you give me out of 10? You first, scoring.
Let's hope Her Majesty doesn't decide to re-watch both seasons of The Crown before bed this year. Neil, Sean, a very Merry Christmas to you and thank you.
See you, Neil. Merry Christmas.
Yeah, mate.
Great Christmas to everybody in the studio. Bye-bye.